So the other day, I overheard somebody talking about how the professional scene isn't professional because players have names that are inappropriate or makes it seem less legitimate. Believe me when I say that the least of our worries in the League of Legends community is a guy who has a summoner named Balls. I just want all of you guys to really realize what's actually going on at the base or the roots of the professional community. So I'm gonna go ahead and compare this, use an analogy so everybody can understand kind of what's going on or what has gone on with a lot of players in the past. Imagine that you're a contractor and somebody hires you to renovate their house. You spend 3 months renovating their house, and after you've done copious amounts of work, they walk into the room and they say, "Actually, you know what? It looks pretty good, but we're not gonna pay you." Does that sound illegal? Pretty sure that sounds legal. Yeah, that's illegal. But that actually happens in the League of Legends community a lot more than people are aware of. And whenever it does happen, it goes on Reddit, and the people that go on Reddit, they read it. They go, "Oh my God, what scumbags?" And that's where it ends. And I don't think that we're having the serious conversations about it that we should be. The most recent example of this kind of scandal, I was actually really close to home for me because I was dating a player, or I am dating a player that did play on that team, Acadian, Top Dog Gaming. I was actually in the house when we were told that the investor had stopped paying for food. I was in the house when we were told that the investor was backing out of a team that had legitimately, it had a gaming house. So this was a legitimate team with a gaming house. The players lived in the house. The players made it to NACS qualifiers, and now they're not getting paid. They made it to qualifiers. They lost, but that's no excuse not to pay what you agreed on. One of the players, Shorter Ace, who I'm close friends with, Ryan, actually took it to Reddit, the Reddit post I put underneath. He talks about how he was promised $1,500 upfront. They took him to the house, and when they got to the house, they offered him a contract that had nothing to do with the money that he was promised, and every time he asked for the money, they would delay it. He's not the only one. Actually, I learned that it was a normal thing for Acadian to tell me, "Oh, you know what? I didn't get paid again this month for the third month in a row. Unlucky." It's not unlucky, dude. That's wrong. That is not okay at all. There's nothing okay about that. They were all told that they did not have to get paid because they did not end up signing. Therefore, no signature equals no money. This happens extremely often, and it comes from a environment not only where players are uneducated, but managers are also uneducated. So you have a bunch of people running around that don't really know what they're doing and having the possibility of money thrown at them with these investors and not knowing how to go about it from a legal standpoint to protect themselves. It's not only just the players. Sometimes it's the managers that get fucked over, and I'm not saying that it's always the managers that fuck the players over. Sometimes it's the investors. But at the end of the day, players need to protect themselves better. We need to have a conversation about how to make sure that the players that are trying to make it to the LCS, or the players that are trying to contribute to the pro scene, are getting compensated properly for what they're doing. These players are like seven, sometimes 16, 17 years old. $1,500 for those players is a lot of money. It doesn't stop there either. The challenger scene is bad enough as it is, but when you move into the NACS, it gets even worse in some instances. If you talk to ManCloud at all or know anything about ManCloud and what happened with Imagine slash Coast and Energy and Martin Shkreli, you would know that basically a team that qualified for the NACS under Imagine had their whole roster replaced after being good enough to qualify into the NACS. Or even teams making it into the LCS and then selling their spots like Coast to Energy, recycling some of those players, and now some of those players are playing in the NACS again. Chris and Shrimp are two of them, and players have to play against these players that had already qualified for the LCS but sold their spot. It's just incredibly it's like something that people don't talk about ever. It's ridiculous. It's something. It's a conversation that we need to have. Players shouldn't be getting ripped off like this. Players like Shorter Race and Low Pally and Slushy and Brandini, Acadian, playing for a team, qualifying, getting into qualifiers and not getting paid. Even players that make it into the NACS getting replaced. Players that make it into the LCS getting replaced and sold. It's asinine. It needs to go past Reddit. It needs to be a conversation that people are having. It's people are getting taken advantage of, and because it's such a fast-growing industry, League of Legends, the pro scene, is growing at a rapid rate. There's money being thrown in it. There's new people that want to invest in teams, and the growing pains are causing people to get extremely screwed over when it comes to compensation. Because people don't know how to handle the money that's being thrown around at this point, and we need to figure it out. It makes me incredibly sad to hear that my friends are not getting what they're promised. It makes me incredibly sad to see some of my friends not be able to pay their rent because they were told that they were going to have the money to pay their rent and they can't pay it this month. It makes me incredibly sad to see players go to a team in a house, think it's legitimate, and then get told, no, you know what, sorry, investor pulled out. This is something that I'm really passionate about because I really enjoy the pro scene, and if we're not keeping it healthy at the base, we can't expect proper growth at the highest level at the LCS. I hope that people listen to this, and I hope that people read the Reddit post that I put down below. I hope that we educate ourselves, and the players take the time to educate yourselves. Please, if you make it on a team, make sure that you get stuff in writing because it is incredibly hard to prove verbal agreement. And also make sure that you're getting your parents, pay the extra whatever, $100 to get a lawyer to look at it. Make sure that it's legitimate. So, whether or not you're a player that didn't get paid, you're a player that got replaced without knowing, even if you're a player that was on a team and told that you were merging with Shkreli and that you were going to get, you know, bonuses and you never see those bonuses, I mean, I'm sorry, and it's something that we need to be aware of as a community, so. I guess I'll leave it with, it is an easy environment for people to take advantage of other people when everyone involved, for the most part, isn't rehearsed or educated when it comes to the legality of promising money for the exchange of money for work, I guess. If you can. Anyways, I hope to make another vlog soon. I'll see you guys later. Thank you for watching. And yeah. See you guys.